Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this powerful glossy black text effect and then how to replace the text quickly and painlessly. I provided this texture for you to download so you can follow along. It's located in the video description or project files. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Click off the eyeball next to the copy to temporarily hide the layer, and click the thumbnail of the background to make it active. We'll darken it by adjusting its levels. Press Ctrl or Command-L to open the levels window. For the highlight output level, type in 100. For the shadow input, type in 90, then click OK. Make layer 1 visible and active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Your image looks dark again because the black layer mask is masking out or hiding the layer that's next to it. We're going to brush white over the layer mask to reveal the lighter background over the darker background. Open your brush tool and make sure the hardness is 0%. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Reduce the opacity to 50% and press Enter or Return. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the brush tip shape panel. Make sure nothing is checked except smoothing. Press F5 again to close the panel. To increase the size of your brush, press the right bracket key. Keep pressing it until your brush is approximately the height of your document. Then, left click twice. Go to the left a bit and left click once. Repeat this on the right. We're ready to set our text. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Abaddon 2 Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make the size 250 points, sharp, and center alignment. The color is irrelevant since we're going to replace the color with a gradient overlay. Type out your text. To center it on your document, click your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select it all. Then, press the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Click the FX icon and choose Gradient Overlay. The blend mode is normal and the style is linear. Make sure Align with Layer is checked and make the angle 90 degrees. Click the gradient bar and click the black-white preset. Click below the gradient bar to add a color stop. Type in 50% for its location. This will place the stop in the center of the gradient. Click the color box, and for brightness, type in 70%, then click OK. Click the lower right stop, and for the location, type in 90%. Click the color box again, and for brightness, type in 45%. Click the lower left stop to create this tiny icon in the middle. Drag it to the right as far as it'll go. Make another stop, and for the location, type in 35%. Click the color box, and for the brightness, this time type in 45%. Create another stop, and for its location, type in 20%. Click the color box, and for the brightness, type in 40%. Then click OK on both windows. Click Satin. Change the blend mode to color burn. The opacity is 50% and change the angle to 160 degrees. The distance is 5 pixels. Open Contour and check the first preset. Make the size 0. Make sure Invert is checked as well as Anti-Alias. Check Bevel and Emboss and check Contour. The style is Inner Bevel and the technique is Chisel Hard. The depth is 300% and the direction is up. The size is 3 pixels The angle is 120 degrees, and the altitude is 30 degrees. The highlight mode is color dodge, and its opacity is 75%. The shadow mode is multiply, and its opacity is also 75%. Click inner glow. The blend mode is color dodge, and the opacity is 37%. Click the color box, and pick a bright color for your bevel's accent. I'm picking a bright aqua color, 00FFEA. The technique is softer, the source is edge, the choke is 0, and the size is 8 pixels. Open contour, and click the lower left preset. Click stroke. The size is 3 pixels, the position is inside, and the fill type is gradient. Click the gradient bar. Click the gear icon and choose metals. When this warning appears, click OK so we can just see the metals gradient in the preset window. Choose the steel bar preset and click OK. Click drop shadow. The blend mode is multiply, the opacity is 50%, and the angle is 120 degrees. Make the distance 5 pixels and the size 5 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we're going to add deeper drop shadows. First, we'll convert it into a smart object so we can change the text and even the font without having to redo the effects that we'll be adding onto it. I'll show you an example later. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Click the FX icon and choose Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply and the opacity is 50%. Make the distance 25 pixels and the size 30 pixels. Make a copy of it and double-click on Drop Shadow to open it in its Layer Style window. Increase the distance to 50 pixels and click OK. If you're working on version CC 2014, I'll show you a simple way to add a bevel with inward curved corners. But first, if you're working on an earlier version of Photoshop, I'll show you how to add a simple rectangular bevel into the metal background. Make the lighter background active. We'll create a new layer above it by clicking the New Layer icon. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangular selection over your text. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the width 8 pixels and the location inside. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Reduce the fill to 0. This makes the border disappear, but any effects we add to it will be visible. Double-click the border layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The technique is chisel hard, the direction is down, and the size is 5 pixels. Then click OK. Reduce the opacity of the border to 80%. To center it, use the same steps as you did earlier. To review, click your Move tool, press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and click the Align Centers icons. Then deselect it. If you're working on version CC 2014, make the lighter background visible and make a new layer above it. Go to Edit and Fill. Choose Pattern, check Scripted Patterns, and choose Picture Frame. Then click OK. The frame window will appear. Open the flyout list of frames and choose Inverse Rounded Corners. I'll make the margin 25, the size 1, the thickness 35, and the angle 25. When you've entered your settings, press Enter or Return. Make the fill 0 and double-click the border to open its Layer Style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. Use the same settings as we had for the other border. The style is inner bevel, and the technique is chisel hard. The direction is down, and the size is 5 pixels. reduce the opacity to 80%. If you want to change the text, double-click the thumbnail of any smart object to open it. If we want it to be a longer word, we first need to widen the canvas, which is represented by the light checkerboard background behind the text. Go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the inches to percent, and for the width, type in 150. You can always increase it later to fit your text. Then click OK. Double-click the large T of the thumbnail to highlight the text and type your new word. Click the check mark to accept it, and then click the small X on the right side of the Smart Object tab. When you see this warning, click Yes to save the changes. Immediately, your text is updated with all the effects and deep drop shadows. To widen the border, click the border layer to make it active, and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to the middle of one of the sides, and when you see a horizontal double arrow, hold down Shift and Alt on Windows, or Shift and Option on a Mac, as you drag out the transform. Then press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.